everybody, welcome back to my channel. My name is Ames and today I'll be sharing a new Pinterest template and a Filmora tutorial. Firstly, I have gathered the images I already want to use. You can prepare your own using either Canva or any other platform you prefer. Here's what you need: an avatar icon, a main image or video if you like, 8 images for the thumbnail, 4 images with darker tint. This is optional if you want the hover effect. So starting in Filmora, I am dragging in the green screen template onto the timeline and I'm choosing to match the frame rate to my media. All the templates you see in this video will be linked in the description box. Now on the timeline, I will add my image below the template layer. Remember that all of the image layers need to be placed below the template. What I'm doing next is to find the accurate frame where the image will start and adjust when the image layer appears. Next, we want to review your image below the template. So to remove the green screen, simply click on the AI matting tool and select the green screen option. Now have a look in your preview and you'll notice that the green screen is now gone and your image is visible. So if you need, you can adjust the tolerance. In my case, I adjusted the tolerance to 20. To avoid any accidental movements of the template layer, I like to lock it first before resizing the images. To resize the images, you can either double click on it within the preview or double click on the image layer itself. A pop-up will appear, giving you more precise control over the width and height dimensions. Now let's take a look at how it's shaping up with the image we've added. This is just the beginning. I am going to repeat these steps for the remaining images, making sure to adjust them so they fit perfectly as thumbnails on the template. This is how it looks like after adding in all the images. Moving on to the hover effect. This is optional, you can skip if you don't wish to do this part, but I promise you it will be worth it if you do. Similarly, we start by adding the image layer and adjust it to the same precise position using the pop-up view earlier. So when the cursor starts to hover on the thumbnail, the darker image will appear to give that appearance of a hover view. We are going to repeat the same steps for the next hover image. Same thing here, we'll just copy the position and scale size dimension from the original image to the hover image. Now we can see that the first two hover effects are ready. It's looking great! We're gonna keep the momentum going by repeating the same steps for the remaining images. Here's a tip. When the cursor bounces back to the other thumbnail, we can simply copy and paste the layer image within the same timeline. Then we will readjust its position so that it reappears when the cursor moves onto that thumbnail again. Now let's take a look at the hover preview. Cool, right? It's time to add in the main image behind it. And it's super simple. All you have to do is drag the image layer to the timing where you want it to appear, and it's done. Remember how I mentioned that all the image layers should be placed below the template layer? Well, for the upcoming steps, we're going to do something different. We actually want the avatar and text to appear on top of the template. So that's what we are going to do. Let's add in our avatar icon. We will manually adjust the scale and position to make it look just right. Simply use the pop-up preview to fine-tune it until you're happy with the result. I duplicated the avatar and repeated it for the second screen as well. And now for the final touch, let's add in some text. To do that, simply click on the T icon located on the top bar. I have added a basic text layer and adjusted it to the timeline where it should appear. For my text, I'm using General Sans font, but feel free to experiment with different fonts that resonate with your style. Play around with the font size to find that perfect balance, and just have fun with it. Duplicate the text for the other thumbnails too, and repeat the same steps for the second part of the template. Here's the final video. Finally, let's talk about exporting the video. I always aim for the highest resolution possible. I will choose the MP4 format and double the resolution for optimal 4K settings when uploading to YouTube. Additionally, I make sure to select the higher quality option to always ensure the best output. When using Filmora, keep in mind that there will be a watermark on the videos. If you wish to export without the watermark, you'll need to choose a plan. Personally, I think it's worth for the quality and ease of control it brings. And by the way, I'm not sponsored for this. Shout out to Filmora. Some of you have asked about recommending free video software, but I have to be honest, while free software can be handy, they often come with limitations that might make editing a bit more tricky. So personally, I prefer using softwares that give me more editing control and a wider range of options. If you're like me and prefer that extra flexibility, I do recommend checking out Filmora. It's a pretty good software that offers a great balance between affordability and features. Also a solid alternative to pricier options like Adobe or Final Cut Pro. So if budget is a concern, you can always take advantage of the free trials or student offers provided by this paid software. It's a fantastic way to test them out and see if they are the right fit for you. Whether you go with Filmora or explore other options, just remember to choose one that best suits your needs and budget. I have a few other templates here that you can check out and download from the link below too, so do check them out. If you like this video, please give a thumbs up and subscribe for more. Feel free to leave a comment on what you'd like to see next, and I'll see you in my next video.